Hello, my name is Osbjorn from Polyfjord, and today I have something different. This program is called Helm, which is the open source synthesizer that you can run on your computer. So download Helm, you can pay for it if you want, you probably should, it's really cool. In Windows, just run it like a regular program, you have a synth. You can make sounds, you can type on your keyboard to make, and you can press X to go up an octave, and then you can press Z to go down. And then all this stuff is probably a little bit confusing, but this is what you need. And that's what we'll be using today. So take your fingers and put them like on the keyboard so you're ready to like. This is a, let's do a C minor. And then let's turn on some reverb. Pretty cool. Let's try this thing, Formant. Pretty cool. And in the mixer, you can turn on the sub. So we're getting a fat note. Now for the cool part. This thing is called arpeggio. It's gonna play your note fast. And this is a free software, guys. It's really cool. So if you hold multiple tones, it sounds like this. And then you can even increase the octave, so it goes two octaves. You don't have to use like the synthesizer note, you can just set this to be noise. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. Let me show you the coolest thing. So now if I press all the notes, I want to just be able to press one note at the same time. I'll explain why. So let's set the voices to one. So it will always jump to the latest note that you pushed. And then let's turn on this thing called porta. It's probably a longer word, but it just says porta here. And then if you set this on. So the trick is to press the first note first, really quickly, and then the second one. So like... Really cool. Someone sounds really excited. Cool. So it's a fun tool to play around with, but we want to record this, and by far the easiest way to record this is to use a program called Audacity, which is also open source. So download Audacity and let's run it. Just search for Audacity and then go to Edit, Preferences, and under Devices, set the host to Windows Wasapi. I have no idea what that is. Recording device, set it to speakers and then loopback and press OK. So now, if I press record, we are recording a sound, and I can go down here and I can just play this. It's not as like the Windows sound. We recorded that. So we are recording every sound that the computer makes. Excellent. Now we can just press record, and we can do our stuff. Oh. Pretty cool. So let's press stop. Let me just zoom out a little bit here. Boop, boop. Boop, be-doop, be-doo. No, that's playback volume. Oh, so here's our sound. Recorded, perfect. So to save this as a file, you can use in your video editing software. Go to File, Export, and select Waveform, or WAV. And then just call it whatever you want. Yep. You don't have to care about this. And then if you want to, you can open up Blender, which is also free and open source. You can go to File, New, Video Editing, just find your sound, drag it in, and if you want to be fancy, you can go to View, Show Waveforms, Waveforms On. And there's our sound.